I've always felt like I could be a good player and make it to the NFL someday. I feel like I had something to prove. I feel like I have something inside of me that, you know, Sam Patrick, you can make it, you can do it, you know, regardless of what you've been through, regardless of where you came from. One day, you know, this incident happened, and me and my dad, I stopped him from hitting my sister. At that point in time in my life, I saw my father as a stranger. And that's when I knew, you know, things were getting kind of crazy. But if me fighting my father meant protecting my younger siblings, then that's what I was going to do.
I went in the house and, you know what I'm saying, I went to my brothers and I asked them, if I go to the council, would y'all go with me? You know, and everybody made that decision that we would. And that's what we did.
When they come in my house, you know, they just come in, just said they're going to take my kids. And I didn't know what they're going to take them for. You know, it was messed up.
When DHS called and said, Coach, we're going to come and get the Willis children and carry them to Haywood County, which is probably about 85 or 90 miles from here. And I said, you can't do that. And they said, well, we have to. And I asked them, could I have time to find someone in our area? And during that process, Coach Finley was in and out of the office, and his first reaction was, we'll take them.
We just knew that we needed to keep them in Brewston because the community knew them and this is their home.
That's not every day that somebody's just gonna come up and take four kids. Not to be, you know, racial or anything about it, but you know what I'm saying, that's four black kids in two white people's homes.
It wasn't like they were getting a bunch of, you know, thug kids or some bad kids or whatever. No, they would get some kids that fortunately went through some bad situation.
I mean, we made the decision in the hopes that we could help them further their education, but I think it's the best decision that we ever made. I think it's bettered our lives because of it.
What can you say about a couple like the Finleys who are 25 and make a decision to bring in four teenagers to their home?
It felt so amazing, like, to be able to, like, you know, eat, you know, and relax and watch, even not have to worry about, you know, whether it's something bad going to happen tonight. I was blessed at that moment. I thank them with all my heart, and I thank them for all of us, and I tell them I love them for it.
Before Patrick left for his final year at the University of Mississippi, he fully expressed these emotions in a letter to the couple he's come to call Mom and Dad.
I just ask that you pray for me each day for good health, strength, just anything you can think of. Well, I'm off now to start and finish my last journey of being a college student and a football player. I just hope when I'm finished, I can make us all proud. Love, Patrick.
Before Patrick could begin his senior season, tragedy struck his already fragile family. Last July, Patrick's youngest brother, Detrus, just 17 years old and on the way to a college football scholarship of his own, drowned while swimming with friends in a local quarry.
Patrick was the rock, and the younger kids kind of look up to him, and he kind of had to be that father figure and tell him everything's going to be okay now. I think through Patrick's strength, I think he was really the one that helped everybody deal through it.
My brother passed. I didn't want to go to school anymore. And Patrick came to me and he told me, he's like, Nika, use it for motivation because that's gonna help you get through. And that makes me feel good because he's making sure that I'm staying on the right path. For Patrick to be there and make sure everybody stayed, you know, stay calm and stay settled, that was a real blessing.
Patrick's inner strength shone through as he delivered the eulogy at his brother's memorial service.
He just basically said that, you know, I'm going to carry Dietrich with me and everything that I do from here on out. And if you let this destroy another life, it's destroyed two instead of just one.
One of the things that my brothers and sisters don't know is that they've also, you know, have done things right too. I mean, they haven't been sent to jail, they haven't been locked up. I was able to feed off them, you know, but I never told them how proud I was of them for, you know, continuing to stay strong. And I wanted to say it out loud, how proud I was and am with them now and how much they affected me in my life.
I look out to them a whole lot, and I hope everybody else does too in the family or whatever, because he's a real good role model. I like him. I like him a lot. I love him a lot, too.
You've had bad experiences with family. You've had great experiences with people who've taken you in as family. How would you define family?
Family It's somebody that, you know, that they love you just as much as you love them. Coach really made sure that they may not be, you know, my biological family or whatever, but them embraced me with open arms.
Patrick's biological mother showed up at Detrus's funeral and tried to work her way back into Patrick's life. But to him, it was too little and too late. Patrick does, however, forgive his father. He works to mend their relationship by visiting whenever he can.
Unfortunately, you know, some of the situation that he chose to, you know, to do wasn't the best, but I guess, but as a human being, you know, I love him to death.
Didn't figure on him going this far, but he stuck with himself. He stuck with himself, you know, and what he had planned to do. So that's great. And I pray, hope he keep making it and hold his head high and keep going where he's going.
I'm proud of Patrick from where he's at and where he's going. I'm proud of all of us. In any type of way, just because we made it from one point to another without breaking apart.
Patrick Willis has willed himself to success in life. He has risen from circumstances where others may have crumbled and overcome everyone's expectations except his own. This past season, which he dedicated to his lost brother, he won the coveted Butkus Award as the nation's top linebacker. And his next goal is to be the first linebacker taken in the NFL draft.
Well, just to be where he is today from where he came from, it's just unbelievable. You really can't put words on how proud we are of him and everything that he's done and everything that he still will accomplish, because I know that in his mind, he's not done yet.
A lot of people look at your story, and when you get drafted, they'll say, oh, what a fairy tale ending.
Maybe it's a fairy tale to some people, but to me, it's life, it's reality. But it won't be the end, you know, because we still got to continue to live. I still got to continue to do things right. I have a strong heart and believe in yourself. You know, you overcome anything.
With the 11th pick in the 2007 NFL Draft, the San Francisco 49ers select Patrick Willis, linebacker, Mississippi.
Boy, is this a good football player. He's a solid person, the Butkus Award winner. Look at the vertical, 39 inches. He ran a 4.51 at the combine. He ran 4.38 at his pro day. Very tough. Excellent instincts. Tremendous straight line speed for an inside linebacker. I believe, and this is a key for a first round linebacker, I think he's a three down linebacker. You can keep him in the game in passing situations. You talk about a physical skill set, plays with leverage, smells the play inside out, then explodes into the tackle. Again, same kind of situation in the Senior Bowl. Stays underneath the play, inside out, and when it's in the open field, explodes to the ball carrier. He translates his natural speed onto the field. Misdirection, doesn't get caught up, knows he's got outside leverage help, plays from the inside out, makes the play in the backfield. Don't just die!